Today is the feast of Saint Joseph Vaz. So how can we become a missionary like him? Christianity is not a Western religion. It originated in the western part of Asia. However, today Christianity has spread all over the world because of the zeal and the sacrifices of missionaries. Today we celebrate such a dedicated missionary. He is Saint Joseph Vaz, the Apostle of Sri Lanka. Father Joseph Vaz was an Oratorian priest who was born and bred in Goa. Once he got to know the misery of the abandoned Catholics in Sri Lanka, he was ready to come and start the mission here. During his era, the Dutch were in control of the coastal belt of Sri Lanka. Therefore, the Catholics were under persecution and all the priests and nuns were expelled by the Dutch. In 1686, Father Joseph Vaz landed in Sri Lanka, disguising himself as a poor beggar. He landed in Jaffna and went from door to door begging for food. That was how he made contact with the Catholics. Gradually, he paved the way for the revival of the Catholic Church in Sri Lanka. Thereafter, he started his mission in the western coastal belt. After establishing Christian communities in the coastal area, he moved to Kandy. There he was suspected as a spy, and he was imprisoned by the king. However, he won the favor of the king and was released. In Kandy, he performed very powerful miracles. He took care of the people when smallpox pandemic was spreading. Father Vaz undertook long missionary journeys throughout the western part of the country. Father Vaz brought missionary oratorian priests here and organized the mission in Sri Lanka in an amazing manner. He spent 24 years in Sri Lanka and made 70,000 Catholics, 15 churches and 400 chapels in our land. Today we are Catholics thanks to the missionary efforts of Saint Joseph Vaz. In today's Holy Gospel, we find the great mission of the Lord. It was the missionary mandate given to the disciples. Just before Jesus ascended into heaven, he called them to a particular place and gave them the final directions. Our Lord said to his disciples, "Go into the whole world, preach the good news to every creature. The man who believes in and accepts baptism will be saved. The man who refuses to accept it will be condemned." During his lifetime, Jesus and his disciples preached only within the boundaries of Israel. Now, at his departure from this world, our Lord tells his disciples to go to all nations and proclaim the good news. Disciples knew only the Jewish language and they had never traveled beyond the boundaries of their motherland. But now, they have to take up the challenge of learning foreign languages and traveling across the globe. They were given a universal mission to baptize everyone who believes. Not only Jesus gave them a missionary mandate, but also he promised them different charisms like driving out demons, healing, and the gift of tongues. After the ascension of Jesus, his disciples went from east to west across the globe spreading the good news. They were not directed by any human strength or wisdom. As missionaries, they were guided by the Holy Spirit throughout their mission. Today, we see the success of the mission of the disciples since there are believers in every nook and corner of this world. In the present day, we are also sent as missionaries into the world. Unfortunately, many have forgotten their mission of carrying the good news to the world. Very especially, lay faithful are the ones who should introduce Jesus to those who do not know him. Today, as believers, we are not demanded to perform incredible miracles, but our Lord wants us to bring light to everywhere there is darkness, to take hope to the places where there is no hope. In the present day era, we don't need to travel thousands of kilometers like Saint Joseph Vaz. We have no threats or persecutions Father Joseph Vaz faced. In our own parish setup, Lord has opened up a lot of avenues for us to be a missionary. There are so many associations like Parish Council, Legion of Mary, Sacred Heart Confraternity, Parish Youth and YCS, where we can engage in the parish pastoral mission. Being a catechist in the Sunday school and being an active member in the church choir are also ways to fulfill our mission. Also, we can engage in charity through the Vincent de Paul Society. Children also can take part in the mission of Christ by actively serving in the Holy Childhood Association or in the Old Service Society. In this manner, God has given us many opportunities within our own parishes to become a missionary. Therefore, let us answer God's call to become a missionary and serve the Holy Catholic Church.